Can we have a moment of silence here to mourn the passing of yet another MMORPG?
If this pain is what it means to have it, then I'd rather be without it.
Yeah, apparently Gameforge just announced today on February 15th, the day after Valentine's Day, that they are shutting down Soulworker Online. They made a blog post titled "Our Adventure is Ending." And you know what? I am gutted. I advocated for this game on literally every occasion I could. This game is one of my favorite hub-based MMOs in the entire market. It is one of the most entertaining anime MMOs, period, with the exception of, you know, like PSO2. And I am just so disappointed that Gameforge went this route. But before we go any further, I do want to note that all hope is not lost. They did go on to state that the official developers of Soulworker are actually working on a global release of the game. So while Gameforge themselves are no longer going to publish the game in Europe and North America, the actual developers themselves will be. But the worst part about that is, if you have dedicated any amount of time to Soulworker, you're going to lose all of your account information, all of your items, all of your gear, all of your characters, your friends. All progress will be completely wiped. As for some reason, I really do not understand why, Gameforge is opting to not transfer all of their data over, which means that Lion Games, I think, is the name of the developer. They are going to be rebooting the game from scratch, which means that if you want to play Soulworker, you're going to have to re-download it, you're going to have to recreate accounts, and you're going to have to re-grind from the ground up. Now, according to the Gameforge official blog post, "Dear Soulworker, regrettably, we must announce today that the adventures in Soulworker will soon be coming to an end. Gameforge will cease operation on the 30th of the 4th, 2021. We will first deactivate payments and then take the servers offline a while later. On the 31st of March, 2021, we will disable payments for Soulworker. From then on, you will no longer be able to top up premium currency. Of course, any remaining premium currency can still be spent until the server are shut down. Lion Games, the development studio of Soulworker, has informed us that there are plans for an international server. However, an account transfer will not be possible. On the 30th of April, 2021, our Soulworker servers will go offline. We are therefore terminating the user contracts on this date. Gameforge accounts will not be affected. You can still continue using them for our other games. Further below in the announcement, you'll find our suggestions for games you can play to make saying goodbye to Soulworker a little bit easier. Together, we have fought in countless skirmishes, experienced thrilling adventures, and our heroism has brought a ray of hope to the post-apocalyptic world of Soulworker. But most importantly, we've met new friends. We've always had a colorful bunch of British, German, French, Spanish, Polish, and Italian Soulworkers, and interestingly enough, they do not list North American Soulworkers there, or I'm actually Australian. They also don't list Australian Soulworkers. So, you know, like both of us have been left out here, even though once again, I've advocated for this game on every occasion and am probably the only content creator on YouTube that still actively does Soulworker videos. And we have formed a unique and creative community. We are grateful for the amazing time we could spend together and will always remember it fondly. What could help you move on from your favorite game better than trying out a new game? Maybe Nostail or Elsword would be good alternatives for you." They then go on to list information about Nostail, which is, in their words, a cuddly anime action game, and then Elsword, but I feel like the majority of you have played Elsword and never want to go back. So they are closing down Soulworker, and what they're saying is, go play one of our other games, because we're going to lose a bunch of players and we'd rather hold on to as many of them as we possibly can. Now, according to the Lion Games Facebook page, they go on to state, "Dear EN/NA users," so at least these guys are actually acknowledging that people outside of Europe exist, "we would like to apologize to our beloved and active users concerning the service termination announcement from Gameforge. As Gameforge announced, current game service in EU and NA will end on the 30th of April due to our publishing contract will be at, well, due to the publishing contract ending." So know that this is, you know, a little bit roughly translated, which admittedly does not bode all too well for the English translations in the Soulworker International version. "But we, Lion Games, will make sure that we continue our service after transforming Soul Worker services into our own, and further questions have been answered in the below Q&A section. Question number one, what contents will be included on the EU/NA server build that Lion Games is producing? Their answer, we aim to provide you with the latest content on our version of service. The version we are preparing right now for the opening will include all 8 characters, including FNL, West War, Second, and Lunarfall. Also, as followed by the launching build, we're planning to include Violent Sun and Lee Navi. Moreover, Cash Store will be reconstructed from the web store into the in-game store, same as other territories, and will include the preview function to try on costumes before purchase. Other gacha items such as roulettes will be excluded from the cash store. There were gacha items in Soul Worker? Question number two, and subsequently answer number two, when is the opening date? An opening date is not confirmed yet. Not only the translation work for newer content, but also revising the previous translation are going on as well to deliver a more sophisticated version of the Soul Worker. Detailed schedules will be shared via our SNS channels once the launching schedule is fixed, so please take that into consideration. Question and answer number three, can I transfer a current account from Gameforge? To provide a solution to transferring users' accounts, we thoroughly considered whether the providable data could be transferred from Gameforge to Lion Games. However, it was technically impossible to get the information required for identity verification based on the general data protection regulation within the EU. See, that I do understand. Hence, we have concluded neither providing account transfer nor receiving any data from Gameforge. Question and answer number four, what will be the difference on service from the Lion Games version of Soul Worker? We are planning to assist your fast growth by providing various items, boosters to participate in raids quickly through our current launching event plan. Also, we're working on an event using merchandise which was held in Taiwan. Further information will be notified once the detailed schedule is fixed. We know that we will have a lot to improve since it is our first time launching in a global region, but we will do our best to make Soul Worker always beloved. And there you have it. Soul Worker Online, the Gameforge incarnation of Soul Worker Online, is ceasing operations. That is, I guess, both a good thing and a bad thing. It's a good thing because, as everyone knows, Gameforge did a terrible job publishing Soul Worker, and Lion Games are the official developers for the game, so they are going to have the ultimate say on what kind of content gets released, how the business model is going to work, what items are going to be in the cash shop. We're going to get content much faster because this is going to be released concurrently with the Asian server instead of waiting for the Asian version of the game to push out content, and then months, if not a year later, actually getting that content over in North America and Europe. Now, it is a sad day when any MMO closes down, that is true. But at the same time, while this is in fact closing down, it is not closing down permanently. We're still going to be able to play the game. You are going to, granted, have to start from scratch, which is ridiculous, but I can understand why. And I hope this incarnation of the game is better than the iteration of the game that Gameforge published. Yes, rip Soul Worker Online for an undisclosed amount of time. This could be months, this could be years before we actually obtain the ability to jump back into the game and play it. But until then, you have what, like 2 months to mess around and enjoy the game until it's gone for however long it's gone for. Anyway, guys, that is pretty much everything I wanted to talk about regarding Soul Worker today. What do you guys think? Are you happy that Gameforge is losing publishing rights to the game? Are you kind of disheartened that the game is going to shut down for an undisclosed amount of time? Let me know down in the comments below and let's talk about it. Anyway, guys, that is it for me. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.